coming through here. It's one of the fur needles, I think. And we've got that mark just here. Measuring how far away it is from the end here. We've got a bit of red coming in there. A tiny bit bigger. They're very close together actually, see? Just having a look at that. Just measuring that. That's far too bulbous there. See that? But it kind of looks alright, doesn't it, really? Just a bit too young grey. Just kind of, it's got more of a smoky feel there. Refine this. This bauble, these baubles have to look real, I think, for it to really for you to understand what it, you know, for everyone to understand what we're trying to do here. Just squinting my eyes a bit here, because it helps. It's a bit better, I think. Okay, so now we want to get on. We'll get on to some of this grey bits. So we can still use the same grey actually, because it's gonna be kind of blended in. They're kind of little marks. They're all kind of going across, and they're kind of coming in a curve. And then here, they're very much darker, see? Just here. Just a bit further than that. Oh God, in my stomach. Time for lunch. There's a little patch here, we can fill in that a bit more. It's coming down to that bit there. Just below those two marks there. Just copying the shapes all the time. That needs to be filled in. Then we've got very on the highlights there. some red there. Fill that corner in there. And here. I've got a little bits, darker bits, then we can fill it in. And this is, now you can see, that's far too low. So we need it up, then up. Then that's filled in there. See, you can still see the white. Then we're going to go over this and kind of just fill in these other bits of white very gently, because they're not white. I've got a nice streaky bit coming in there and a dark mark just there. Got a dark mark there. So we'll fill this in, fill this in here. Right, so we can kind of go over and fill most of this in now, I think. Just fill in. Leave the lighter areas, there's a lighter area there, I can leave that. Then we've got a different colour coming through here. But we'll just pop this on. And it's going in a nice curve, but not too curved. And it's above that mark we've already put in, see? But we're just doing it around like that. That's it. This is lighter down here, so you can see there's some dark, little darker patches. Slightly darker. Just work it through like that. This is not white, very slightly grey, but light. This needs to be grey on the edge. Leave that white bit there, leave that there. Right to there. This needs to be grey. Lighter. Okay, so now we're going to get that brownie colour in, which is like a mossy. I wonder if that'll be kind of. We've got a mossy, rusty colour, but that'll probably go okay over the grey actually. Try it. Yeah, it's alright. I'll put a bit of brown in that as well. Now there are little lines. But they're haphazard, they're not uniform. So just put bits of colour in that. Got a bit of grey that we need to put in there. Mist in the middle here. Just here, see? line going across there. Very fine. This is the Faber-Castell pencil, which is very hard. It's good for doing stuff like this. Now, all these marks can look a little bit harsh, but then we'll just tap it with our fingers. So you can go over those darker grey bits now with the black, but not strongly and not uniform, because it will be slightly different. Looking all right, I think. Darken this down a bit. It's not black, it's brown. So put a bit of brown on that. We get around to that before we finish. And this is, it's not black either, but it's very dark. Put a bit more in there. A little bit on the bottom. So let's have a look at that. Okay, what needs to be happening now is I need to put some shading. If you look really carefully at this, the white bits have got shading in. It's very, very faint. You don't want to make it all look cloudy and unpleasant. But it definitely needs something doing to it there. What's happening is, it's my grey, it's disappeared now. That's brown. Oh, it's in my hand. Hardly a thing. Grey bits in this. Clean finger. I'm just going to tap it all back. Look at that. And what I do with it is just wipe it on a piece of paper towel or my trousers. See? Just softens everything. Sight of that now. It's not exactly the same shape, but when we get this lightened off here, which we can do now actually, just do that, make it look right. But we still have to get a bit of shadow under here, so it's not white. Of course, we must get some kind of sharp edge here to show that that's the end of the bauble. That's better. See, it's so much better. Get the contrast of the white around it is much better. I just want to soften that a little, so I'll get the colour shaper. It's a very soft one, see, very, very soft. I just sort of go over it and Just merge them colours together a little bit. Like that. It'll work now because we've taken a lot of the pastel off. Just like that. Back. It's a bit longer, isn't it? And then some white in there. And look at my white bits. Too high. That's what it'll do, I think. We can get too fussy about this. We mustn't get too fussy about this. It'll be here forever. It's no good. More of the reddy brown in here just to make it look a really different colour. Okay, I need bright red now. Go around that top, and that should sort it out now. It's quite nice and sharp. Okay, so we're gonna just need to get on top. Really need some lunch. Right, there. That's not bad. Get some greens. some of these here. Looks a bit wonky, but you know, he could be moving around, so let's leave him alone. It's just a little bit of grey down here. See, these marks in the white highlights are giving the effect of it coming around and in. We've got a brown bit of fur coming across there, which is quite good. If I can find my dark brown, I'll put that in. Yeah, this kind of looks pretty good. It's coming right on the top of that. Some nice bits coming over here. These are coming over the top of the cone. You need to put some bits of white in the cone to make it look a bit more three-dimensional. It's a bit here. finish for now. See you later.